My dear students, in this lecture we shall learn about alkyl free radicals. What are alkyl free radicals? Alkyl free radicals are formed due to the homolytic fission of a covalent bond between carbon and hydrogen in an alkane. For example, CH4 is methane. There are four covalent bonds between carbon and central carbon atom and hydrogen atoms. If one of the bonds between carbon and hydrogen breaks homolytically, that is, one electron of the covalent bond goes to hydrogen, another electron of the covalent bond goes to carbon, then a hydrogen atom is eliminated. Hydrogen atom can be written like this, H one electron. Carbon, this CH3 group will have one electron. This is called methyl free radical and this is called hydrogen free radical. This methyl free radical is same as the methyl group we have learnt in previous lecture. But methyl group is written as CH3 small dash, that is one free valence. If CH3 is written with one small dot, that is one unpaired electron, it is methyl free radical. If methyl group with a free valence, that is one small dash, it is called methyl group. It can be also written like this, CH3 small dash. Similarly, ethane, C2H6, this can be written as C2H5H. The bond between carbon and hydrogen cleaves homolytically, so hydrogen gets one electron and carbon gets one electron. So we get ethyl group C2H5 small dash and hydrogen atom H small dash. This hydrogen atom. This is the same thing. If we can write with unpaired electron, it is called free radical. Same thing he repeated here, C2H5 and H. The bond between carbon and hydrogen cleaves homolytically with the liberation of one hydrogen atom. We get C2H5, one unpaired electron. This is ethyl free radical. Hydrogen with one unpaired electron, hydrogen free radical. So, don't get confused with free radicals and groups. They are one and the same, but nobody tells this. Okay. Many a time we get the doubt, what is free radical, what is a group? They are one and the same. For the reaction's sake, sometimes we call them free radicals, sometimes we call them groups. So alkyl group and alkyl free radical are same. Methyl group, methyl free radical is same. Ethyl group, ethyl free radical is same. Okay. So don't get confused with them. Now let us see the types of alkyl free radicals. First one is primary or first degree free radical. If the unpaired electron is present on a primary carbon atom, it is called primary free radical. So if the free radical is present on primary carbon, it is called primary free radical. See, this is a methyl free radical. The free radical is present on this carbon. There is only one carbon. It is a primary carbon because it is not connected to other carbon atoms. Since the radical is present on primary carbon, it is called primary free radical. Similarly, C2H5 radical. This is a primary carbon as it is connected to only another carbon atom. If the carbon is connected to only other carbon, it is called primary carbon. Since the radical is present on primary carbon, it is called primary free radical. Now let us see secondary free radicals. So this is isopropyl free radical. As you know, propane has three carbon atoms, 1, 2, 3. The radical is present in the middle, on the middle carbon, so it is called isopropyl free radical. This carbon is connected to two other carbons, so it is a secondary carbon. And since the radical is present on secondary carbon, it is called secondary free radical. So isopropyl free radical is secondary free radical. Now let us see tertiary free radical, that is 3 degree free radical. This is tertiary butyl free radical, CH3 connected to a carbon atom which is having a free radical. This carbon is connected to three other carbons, so it is called a tertiary carbon. As the free radical is present on the tertiary carbon, it is called tertiary free radical. So there are three types of free radicals: primary free radical, secondary free radical, and tertiary free radical. Primary free radical is not connected to any other carbon atom, or it is connected to only one carbon atom. These are primary free radicals. Secondary free radical, the carbon is connected to two other carbons, so it is secondary carbon. The radical is present on secondary carbon, so it is secondary free radical. Tertiary carbon is connected to three other carbon atoms, so the radical present on the tertiary carbon will become tertiary free radical. These are the types of free radicals. Thanks for watching. Please share and subscribe.